This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to use CVP analysis or cost volume profit analysis for companies that have multiple products and for companies that have services. Right now we'll focus on companies that have multiple tangible products, and later in this video we'll talk about companies that have services, that provide services. So the profit equation is where we're going to start. And let's assume here we're talking about a company that has two products, and for lack of a better name, product one and product two. And this profit equation that you see right here then shows us how to find the profit for a company that has multiple products, in this case, two products. We find the profit by looking at the first product and taking the unit contribution margin for the first product times the quantity of the first product. And remember that the unit contribution, this is from a prior video, the unit contribution margin is calculated as the sales price per unit minus the variable cost per unit. And for this, it would be for that particular product. Whatever the sales price is for that product per unit minus the variable cost per unit for that product would be the unit contribution margin. We would then do the same thing, add to that the unit contribution margin for product 2 times the quantity of product 2. If we had 100 products, we would do this for each of those 100 products, and then from there subtract the total fixed costs, and that's how we would find the profit for a company that has multiple products. The profit equation then is used to derive what you see here, the break-even point equation. So this comes right from that profit equation. I'm not going to derive it here, but this is comes directly from that. So to find the break-even point for a company that has multiple products, and I'm talking about the break-even point in units, for a company that has multiple products, we would take total fixed costs, add to that the target profit. If it's a break-even point, the target profit would then be zero, and divide that by the weighted average contribution margin per unit. So if we sell multiple products, well, what is the weighted average unit contribution margin for all of those products that we sell? So we're going to talk about that next, how to find that weighted average contribution margin per unit. Let's look at a company that sells kayaks, and the company is called Kayaks-For-Fun. This company has two products. We've got a river kayak and a sea kayak. And as you can see here, the selling price for each of these is shown. So it's $500 for the river kayak and $600 for the sea kayak. The variable cost per unit is also shown here, $100 for the river kayak and $450 for the sea kayak. And therefore, the contribution margin is the difference between the two. Because remember, the selling price is S, variable cost per unit is V, and S minus V gives us the contribution margin. So the contribution margin per unit for the river kayak is $400 and $150 for the sea kayak. Now we just need to know the sales mix for each of these products. And we see that in the next bullet point, that the river model represents 60% of total sales and the sea model represents 40% of total sales. With that information and with the unit contribution margin up above for each of those products, we can figure out the weighted average contribution margin per unit. And that's shown right here. Remember, we needed that to find the break-even point in the previous slide. So we're figuring out the weighted average contribution margin per unit, and it's $300. That $300 comes from the $400 per unit for the river kayak unit contribution margin times 60%, and then we add to that the $150 for the sea kayak unit contribution margin times 40%. So that gives us a weighted average contribution margin per unit of $300. Now we have everything that we need to figure out the break-even point at Kayaks-For-Fun. So that's what we're doing here. We're going to simply take the total fixed costs, and we're doing this on a monthly basis, so we're looking at the monthly fixed cost of $24,000. We want to find the break-even point, so our target profit is zero, and we divide that by the weighted average unit contribution margin that we just figured out on the previous slide of $300. And that tells us that we need to sell 80 kayaks per month to break even. We can split that out, if you like, into each of the kayaks, types of kayaks. We can take the sales mix for each of those kayaks and multiply that times the 80, and that would give us then how many of the sea kayaks we would need to sell and how many of the river kayaks we'd need to sell. But in total, we have to sell 80 kayaks to break even on a monthly basis. Now we're going to change the focus to finding the break-even point or target profit in sales dollars. And this can be for companies that have multiple tangible products like kayaks, or it could be a company that offers services. And we're going to look on the next slide at a company that has accounting services, and we'll show you how this works. The equation for finding the break-even point in sales dollars is the total fixed cost plus the target profit, so this plus this, divided by the weighted average contribution margin ratio. So we need to be able to figure out the weighted average contribution margin ratio to find the break-even point in sales dollars, and we'll look at that on the next slide. Again, our focus right now is on a service company and how to find the break-even point or target profit point in sales dollars for a service company. The example that we have here is for an accounting firm that has three different areas of services that are provided. We've got a tax department, an audit department, and a consulting department. The idea is to figure out, we want to know what the break-even point is in sales dollars, and so the idea here is to figure out the weighted average contribution margin ratio. You'll see here that the contribution margin is stated for each of these areas. Tax is $70,000, audit is $30,000, consulting is $125,000. And we could find out the contribution margin ratio for each of these areas. We could take $70,000 divided by $100,000, that's 70%, and that would give us the contribution margin ratio for tax. But we want the contribution margin ratio overall for the entire company. What is the average contribution margin ratio? So to find that, because you'll notice it's different for each of these departments, so we can't just say it's 70% for the entire company. It varies. It depends on the department. So to find that weighted average contribution margin ratio, we need the total information for the company, and you'll see that in this column right here. And from that, we can take the total contribution margin ratio and divide that by total sales, and that will give us the weighted average contribution margin ratio. You'll see that down here in the formula that we've got $225,000, that's our total contribution margin, and we divide that by $500,000 in total sales, comes right from up above in the total column, and that gives us a contribution margin ratio, when you do the math, of 45%. And remember, we need that to find the break-even point in sales dollars, so we're going to take a look at that on the next slide. Now we have everything we need to find a break-even point in sales dollars for this accounting firm that we've been looking at. The break-even point, as you recall, the formula is the total fixed costs plus the target profit, zero if it's a break-even point that we're looking for, and we are, divided by the weighted average contribution margin ratio that we just figured out on the previous slide. If you run the numbers, this company needs to have sales of $822,222, kind of an odd number because it's rounded, but $822,222 to break even. So to equate that to this chart down here, if we were to redo the numbers, we won't do it here, but if we were to do the redo the numbers, this means we would need to have in total $822,222 to achieve zero profit to break even. So that's what that information tells us. We have to have $822,222 in sales to break even. Anything above that in sales, and we should have profit. Anything below that in total sales, and we should have losses. Lastly, there are some important assumptions that we have to make when performing cost, volume, profit analysis with companies that have multiple products or services. And they're listed here. I'll go through them quickly. First of all, costs. We must be able to separate our costs into fixed and variable components. And there are several different lectures that I've posted that explain how we are able to do that. But we have to be able to separate our costs into fixed and variable components. And then secondly, the contribution margin ratio within each product segment or department. In the previous example, it was that the accounting company with the different segments. The contribution margin ratio for each of those segments, for example, the tax segment, those ratios have to remain constant. So that's an important one. I think we had calculated that the tax contribution margin ratio was 70% for the tax department. That 70% has to remain constant as we run these calculations. And then lastly, we have to assume that the sales mix remains constant with changes in total sales. So those are the three very important assumptions that we make as we run CVP analysis for companies with multiple products or services. If any of these assumptions change, then we have to go back and redo the analysis to make sure that it's accurate.